numbers. In this rational number, we are going to see that how to represent the rational numbers on a number line, and then here comparison of rational numbers. These two things we are going to see in this video. If you like our video, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Come, let's see what is there in the first question. So 3 by 4. The first question is mentioned as 3 by 4. So here 3 is the numerator and 4 is the denominator. So 4 is the denominator. So first thing what we have to do, as soon as you see the 4 as a denominator or any number as a denominator, what you have to do is the number we specify, right? On this, in the center we specify with 0 and then 1, 2, 3, right, right side, and left side minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like that. So first thing, as soon as I see that the denominator is 4, I have to specify the 0 with the denominator 4, so that our divisions, the number of divisions will be easy for us to do it, and then we can represent 3 by 4 very easily. That is why we have to specify the denominator with 4. Next thing is, after 0, the next number should be 1, right? So that 1 is here. As a whole number, that 1 is here. Here this is 0, right? So as a whole number, the 1 is here. But in between, why we have divided? I will tell you now. So first thing, I told you that denominator we should specify with 4. And the second clue is, you have to check whether the above number, that is numerator, is greater than the denominator or lesser than the denominator. So now if I see, it is lesser than the denominator, right? So what I need to do lesser than the denominator means I will get a clue that it will fall between 0 and 1. The whole number 0 and 1, the number, the rational number which is given here, will fall between 0 and 1. That's what is the second clue for you. So here, now what I told you, 0 by 4, we have to specify 0 by 4, after that next number will be 1 by 4, and then 2 by 4, and then 3 by 4, and then 4 by 4. So the 3 by 4 falls before 4 by 4, right? So this is the number which you want to represent on the number line, because that is the question. Come, let's see what is the next number. Here minus 7 by 8. So it is in a negative number. It is a negative number. And here you got a positive number, right? So negative number here. So what we need to do is, the answer represents towards the left hand side. That is the negative integers, right? So here, first clue, as I told you, the number denominator you should specify with the 0. 0 which has a denominator as 8. Like that we have to write. And then next thing I told you, we have to check whether the number is, the denominator is greater than the numerator or it is lesser than the denominator. So if I check, the number is lesser than the denominator. So I will get a clue that it is falling between 0 and minus 1, right? If it is a positive number, it will be 0 and plus 1. Then here, why it is given as 8? Because we have to divide the numbers, that is divide the number lines from 0 to minus 1 with 8 divisions, right? So with 8 divisions. So now 0 by 8 is here, next number will be minus 1 by 8, next number will be minus 2 by 8, minus 3 by 8, minus 4 by 8, minus 6 by 8. Sorry, 5 by 8, minus 6 by 8, minus 7 by 8. So, minus 7 by 8 is here. And this minus 1 will be represented as minus 8 by 8. Then only we'll get the answer as minus 1. No. So, we know that the denominator is 8. So, when we divide denominator as 8 with minus 8, we'll get the answer as minus 1. So, minus 7 by 8 falls before 0, between 0 and minus 1. So, minus 7 by 8 is here. So, we can represent easily. The next number is minus 7 by 3. So, minus 7 by 3 means, I told you already, first thing is, what the thing is you have to do is 0 by 3. That is, the denominator should be specified as 3 for the 0. Next is, second thing is that you have to check whether the numerator is greater than the denominator or lesser than the denominator. For first two, you have seen that both are lesser than the denominator. But here it is greater than the denominator. So greater than the denominator means, you know that when we divide 3, it comes 3 twos are 6 and remainder will be 1. So the 2 whole number, you got it. So for the 2 whole number, why we need to get the whole number here is, we'll get an idea how long we have to specify the number line. That is, with 1, 2, 3, till which number we have to specify that, to get that idea. So, here 2 we got it, right? So, what we need to do? Minus 2. Till minus 2 we have to specify. It goes beyond that. We'll get an idea. Because it is 7 by 3. So, here minus 2. After 0, minus 1, then minus 2. So, minus 2 will be specified as minus 6 by 3. Why, children? Because 3 is the denominator. So, when I divide minus 6, I get minus 2. Similarly, when I do minus 3 by 3, I get minus 1, right? So, this is how we have to specify. And next thing is, right side also we have to specify like that. If you don't specify also, it's fine, because we need to get the answer in negative. So 0 by 3 is here. We need to divide between minus 1 and 0. 2 divisions. Third division should be minus 1. So minus 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, minus 3 by 3, minus 4 by 3, minus 5 by 3, minus 6 by 3. What is our representation? Minus 7 by 3. So it will fall after this. So minus 7 by 3. So this is the answer how we have to represent the minus 7 by 3 on this number line. Now let's see comparison of rational numbers. The first question given here is minus 4 by 3 is compared with 2 by 6. So, one negative number, another one is positive number. So, when different, the signs are there, what we have to do, it's very simple, children. 2 by 6 is a positive number, right? So, the positive number is always greater. So, 2 by 6 is greater than minus 4 by 3. Very simple. Yes, here 14 by 3 and minus 25 by 6, similarly of that first example, right? Similar to the first example. So 14 by 3 is a positive number and minus 25 by 6 is a negative number. So 14 by 3 is the greater number. Very simple. Come, let's see when two positive numbers are compared and two negative numbers are compared, we'll see how to do it. Yes, 8 by 3. And 7 by 2. If you see, the denominators are different. It's not same. So, as soon as I see the denominators are different, I have to do LCM. So, when I do LCM, I'm getting the answer as 6. Right? So, what is the next step? I have to make the denominator as 6. So, 8 by 3, 2 by 2. When I multiply it, I'll get the answer as 16 by 6. Why we need to do by 2? 8 by 3 should be multiplied by 2 by 2. Why, children? Because 3 multiplied by 2 will give the answer as 6. That is why we need to multiply by 2. Because we need to get the denominator as 6, since we got the LCM as 6. So 8 multiplied by 2. We have to multiply with the numerator also the same number as we have seen in the equivalent rational numbers. So 8 into 2 is 16 and 3 into 2 is 6. So 16 by 6 is the answer. And now 7 by 2. Even 7 by 2, we have to make the denominator as 6. So with 2, if I multiply 3, then only I get 6. So I am multiplying with 3 also with the numerator, right? Not only with the denominator. So 7 by 2 multiplied by 3 by 3. So 7 threes are 21 and 2 threes are 6. So we got the answer as 21 by 6. Now it is easy for us to compare when the denominators are same. So 16 by 6 and 21 by 6. So 21 by 6 is the greater, because here 16 is a smaller number and 21 is the greater number. So we got only, you have to check the numerator because the denominators are same. So after this, the 16 by 6, the original value from the question, you are writing that is 8 by 3 and 21 by 6 as the original value 7 by 2. So here 7 by 2 and 8 by 3, you have to write the original numbers. So now we know that 21 by 6 is greater. So 7 by 2 is the actual value. So 7 by 2 is the greater number. Now next question is minus 3 by 18 and minus 8 by 6. These two we are comparing. So when we are comparing two negative integers, the same way we will do how we have done with the positive rational numbers. But here one difference is there. You will come to know at the last. So minus 3 by 18, right? So the denominators are different again. So I'm taking the LCM. When I take the LCM, the answer is 18. So answer is 18. What I need to do, I have to make the denominator as 18. So for the first number, it's already 18. You don't have to multiply with any number. Or if you, I feel like you are feeling, you know, the confusion. So what I did is, I just multiplied with 1. So you will be thinking that with which number I have to multiply? Already 18 is there. So it's very simple, 1 only. Or if you don't do it directly, if you are writing also, it's fine. Now next is minus 8 by 6. So minus 8 by 6 multiplied by 3 by 3. Why I have done with 3 by 3? Because I need to get the answer as 18 in the denominator. So to get the denominator as 18, I need to multiply 6 with the 3. That is why I multiplied with 3. So we got the denominator as 18. And now along with the numerator also I have to multiply 3. Why? Because to get the equivalent rational numbers. So when we get equivalent rational number, then only we can compare, because the denominator will be equal. So minus 8 into 3 is minus 24, and 6 into 3 is 18. So minus 24 by 18. So minus 3 by 18, I'm comparing with minus 24 by 18. Actual number which is greater, children, 24 is greater, right? But compare with 3, right? But here negative symbols are there. Negative is specified. So when negative is specified, the smaller number is the greater number, right? The smaller number is the greater number. So minus 3 by 18 is a greater number compared with minus 24 by 18. So we are here, we specified that minus 3 by 18 is a greater number, and then the original value of the numbers which is given here from the question, you have to specify. So minus 3 by 18 is greater than minus 24 by 18 is what? 8 minus 8 by 6. So we are writing here minus 8 by 6. But what, which is greater, children? Minus 3 by 18 is greater. Thank you, children. Thank you for watching my video. Please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.